What's up guys, my name is Andre. Welcome back to my channel. Now, as we speak, there's currently a Steam Summer Sale going on. For those of you who don't know, the Steam Summer Sale is like the granddaddy of gaming sales. What I was gonna do originally was go through the process of me buying games, and I was gonna take you on that journey with me, but then I realized that that was gonna be a really boring video because all I do is just scroll up and down for an hour trying to match up prices to see what the best deals are, and that's not gonna be a fun video. So the next idea that I had was to show you my game collection. Then I realized I have so many games that this will take probably an hour. So what I'm gonna do officially is I'm gonna show you two parts of my collection. I'm mainly a PC gamer now. I used to be big into consoles, but now I mostly play on PC, but I do have a lot of love for consoles. So in this very video, I'm gonna show you guys my console game collection, and then in the next one I'll show you my PC game collection. Click that like button if that sounds good to you, and let's get the show on the road. So I'm gonna start off with the PlayStation 3, because even though that system had a really rocky start, in the end it ended up with having probably the best, or easily one of the best game libraries from any console in my opinion. So let's get started with the PlayStation 3. I'm gonna go through these pretty quickly. I don't want this video to be too long, but I do want to focus on some of the games. First game is 3D Dot Game Heroes, which is like, the graphics are almost like 8-bit, but they're 3D. It's a very under the radar game. It's pretty much an original Zelda copy or homage. I don't know what you want to call it, but this game is really fun. I haven't had a chance to beat it, but I had a lot of fun with the few hours that I spent playing it. Next, I have Battlefield Bad Company. I love this Battlefield. I beat it multiple times on Xbox 360 back in the day when it came out. Then I beat it a couple times on the PS3. I love this. It's like a war game, like most Battlefield games, but there's like a charm and humor to it, to the main characters. And I just love the camaraderie between them and all the little one-liners and jokes that they do. It's like a war game that's pretty intense, but it's also lighthearted. So that's what I like that. Next we have is Beyond Two Souls. I've not played this one either. I really want to play it for my channel because it's one of those games which is story-based and like your decisions create the outcome of the game. This game is on PS4, but it's digital only, and the problem is I want to play it for my channel, but I can't record my PS3 because it has like HDMI protection. So I'm kind of waiting for a sale for the PS4 version so that I can play it for my channel. Next, I have Condemned 2 Bloodshot. I have not played either one of the Condemned games. For some really odd reason, Condemned 2 is not on PC. It's only on Xbox and PlayStation 3. Another game that's oddly not on PC is The Darkness, even though The Darkness 2 is on PC. I really want to play this, but my PlayStation 3 doesn't get much playtime nowadays, unfortunately. Next, I have Dante's Inferno, which I have not played either. Guys, just wait until I get into my PC collection. You think I haven't played anything now? Just wait until I get my PC collection. Next is the Devil May Cry collection, which is the first three PS2 games in one HD remaster collection. I've played the first one for a bit, and I have not played the other ones. It was really hard though, from what I played. Next is Folklore. I don't know why I have this, and I have not played it, and I don't know if I ever will. It's not really my type of game, but it's a PS3 exclusive, and it's pretty under the radar, and maybe I should just try it out one day. Ghost Recon Advanced Warfighter 2. I've played the original Advanced Warfighter on Xbox 360, and that was a lot of fun. But once again, I've not played this one. But don't worry, guys. We're finally getting to some games that I have played. The granddaddy of HD remasters collections, guys. This is the God of War collection, which is God of War 1 and 2, which were PS2 games, which I love to death. These were my first Platinums, I think. Platinum trophies on PlayStation, so good memories, good times, love God of War. And we're gonna continue with God of War, which is God of War 3. Love this game, also Platinum did. This was a great, at the time, finale to the series. Got more God of War. This is the Origin Collection. This is the HD remasters of the PSP games, which I never got a chance to play on the PSP. So I was very happy to play them on the PS3 with better graphics and better controls and all that. And I got a Platinum on each one of these too, so the whole God of War series is complete for me, besides God of War Ascension. For some reason, I got about halfway through it, I just wasn't really feeling it. Maybe I just was God of War'd out? I don't know, I gotta finish this, I think, someday. Next we have GoldenEye 007, the Reloaded, not remastered, Reloaded, even though this is pretty much the remake of the N64 game, but also it's kind of like, it's just Call of Duty with James Bond paint job. Although it is based on the movie GoldenEye, except it's, instead of Pierce Brosnan, we have Daniel Craig, which looks really weird because they reenact some of the scenes from the movie, except, like I said, instead of Pierce Brosnan, it's Daniel Craig. Next is one of my all-time favorites, Heavy Rain. Absolutely love this. Also really want to get this game on PS4 and replay it for the channel. Nasty GameStop sticker. Or no, it's not a GameStop sticker. I don't know. But anyways, just love this game so much. I love Rain in games, so this had a lot of it, and it just blew my mind when I played it. Finding out who the killer was, like, kept me guessing the whole way. I love games like this now, like The Walking Dead, the Telltale games in general, Until Dawn. Really looking forward to Detroit Become Human. Next we have an amazing series, Infamous. I love this game. When I first started it, way back, like 8 years ago or 7 years ago or whatever, I wasn't really feeling it, but then I waited a few months and then started it again, and I just loved it. I loved the twist ending to this game. I just loved the whole game. It was so much fun. It was a superhero game, except it's not based on any superheroes that we know. It's like started from scratch, and I just loved it. That brings me to Infamous 2. Now, I'm not even gonna hide the fact that I beat this game in one sitting. Like, literally, I remember I got it from Gamefly. Do you guys know what Gamefly is? Does that even exist anymore? Basically, it's a rental service where you get games in the mail. I got it in the mail. The next morning, I put the game in, and by 11 p.m., I beat it. I was just so into it. Except, since I did that, I don't really remember anything about it. All I remember is like a big monster going through the US map or something. Really wish they made a HD collection on the PS4 for this. Next, we have another classic trilogy, the Jack and Dexter trilogy. Before Uncharted came out, Jack 2 and Jack 3 were my all-time favorite games. And it's a coincidence that they're made by Naughty Dog, both of them. But I love this series. Played Jack 2 and 3, I've beaten them probably 4 or 5 times each. Jack 1, I don't really care that much about because it's like a collect-a-thon. I'm not a big fan of running around collecting stuff. But Jack 2 and 3, the storyline's amazing, the graphics were amazing, the gameplay was amazing, even though some of it was stupid hard. But just so many memories. I love this series. Next, we have the Killzone Collection. I did have Killzone 2 and 3 individually, but I got this collection because I don't really like, at the time, I didn't really like digital downloads, and the only way to get Killzone 1 on disc was to buy this. So this includes Killzone 1, 2, and 3. I've never beaten Killzone 1, but I've beaten Killzone 2 a couple times. Loved the game, it was amazing, but the last boss made me like freaking pull my hair out. And then Killzone 3 was really short. It's another one where me and my friend, we beat it in one sitting. But it was a lot of fun, a lot of jetpacking, and one of the things, this is kind of a off topic, but when Killzone 3 came out, I had a paralyzed left hand. It was barely functioning from surgeries, and I beat Killzone 3 with basically one hand. One and a half hands, let's just say that. So that was a big achievement for me. Keeping it moving, Little Big Planet, really, really fun concept. I remember this game was super hyped when it first came out. Everybody loved it. It was a platforming game, but I don't really like the floaty physics. I'm not really a big fan of that. I still enjoy this game quite a bit, especially in co-op. It was hilarious. I think it was this one that I played 4-player co-op online, and I remember it was just hilarious because you could like grab people's heads, like your teammate will walk up to you or your partner or whatever, you just get on top of his head and get stuck to him, and like it's hard to describe, but it's hilarious. Really fun game. Unfortunately, I haven't played much of either the first one or the second. Metal Gear Solid Collection. This includes Metal Gear Solid 2, Metal Gear Solid 3, and Peace Walker, which was a PSP game. I've never played any Metal Gear Solid game, even up to this point, so I don't have much to say other than the fact that I really need to play this because I feel like I'm really missing out on a lot of these franchises, not just this one. Everything I just said about the Metal Gear Solid Collection goes for this, Metal Gear Solid 4, I remember when this came out, this was really like the big game for PS3, because PS3 was struggling for the first couple years against the 360, and this really put it like on the map, I think. This got like 10s out of 10 and 11 out of 10 on everything. Next I have Midnight Club Los Angeles, and this is the complete edition with the nasty Greatest Hits red box. I hate Greatest Hits boxes, but I think the only way to get the complete edition is to get the Greatest Hits, so what are you gonna do? I really miss the Midnight Club series. I really hope Rockstar makes another one, because it's been almost a decade since this came out. I think this was 2008. And this game is just so much fun. It's so frustrating, it's so difficult, but you just feel such a relief when you beat a race, or like when you're driving a motorcycle and you just barely squeezing between cars, and it's so satisfying. It's such an adrenaline rush, and I just love this series so much. I love the third one on the PS2. I played that over and over and over. I even played it on the PSP over and over and over, and then when this came out on 360, played it over and over. Then I played it on PS3 over and over. I just love this game and the series. Next we have Mod Nation Racers, which I really enjoyed. I think this was a great concept, and actually it was executed really well too, in my opinion. It's almost like a Little Big Planet, but for kart racing games, like Mario Kart, but with complete control of creativity. Like, you can create anything. I remember, and not only can you create, you can download characters that people created. So I remember playing as like Scorpion and Sub-Zero for Mortal Kombat, because people would just create them and they would look amazing, and people created Mario who looked amazing, and people created Spider-Man and all kinds of superheroes. Basically, if you can imagine it, you can pretty much create it in this game, and not just the characters, but tracks, vehicles, all kinds of stuff, and it was fun to play. But I feel like not very many people got to play this, so that's very unfortunate. I would love to see a new edition of this on the PS4. I think that would be amazing. Next, I have Ninja Gaiden Sigma 1, the first one. I've not played this one very much. I only played the first level, but I have played the second one a lot, which I unfortunately don't have. I used to have it on 360. Dark Souls is known for being really difficult and frustrating, but a lot of people are forgetting about Ninja Gaiden. This is the Dark Souls before Dark Souls. This will make you wanna snap your own neck or something like that. Like, bang your head against the wall, break the controller, break the TV, break whatever's in your path. This game will make you do it. Ni No Kuni, Wrath of the White Witch. Guys, I'm not into JRPGs at all, but this game just sounded so promising, and I still have yet to play it. I think there's a second one coming out on the PS4, so I'm wondering if they're gonna remaster this on PS4. I kinda hope so I can record it from my YouTube channel and experience it with you guys, but if not, I feel like I just need to play this before the second one comes out. Next is PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale, which is obviously the infamous knockoff of Super Smash Bros. Of course, this is not as good as Smash Bros, but I think this was a really fair attempt at making a similar game. It's not completely similar, but it's pretty similar. It's not like a straight up copy. I don't know, it's pretty enjoyable. I enjoyed it. I really liked it. And me and my friends, we had some good times with this. Next is the Prince of Persia Trilogy Remastered. Or is it remastered? No. Oh, it is a remaster. Remastered in high definition. I don't even know what they call some of the collections, but this game doesn't hold up very well. Well, I've only played the first one. I haven't played the second or third one. But the first one doesn't really hold up very well. It's kind of frustrating, but it's still a classic. It's still a lot of fun. It was amazing when it first came out on PlayStation 2 and Xbox and GameCube. I remember loving that game. And also remember not being allowed to play the second and the third because they were rated mature. So, oh my gosh. Puppeteer. To be honest, I don't know much about this game. I'm not really sure why I have it. I do recall hearing that it's pretty good though, so that's all I have to say. Next, I have Ratchet & Clank Collection, amazing series. I love this whole series, even the games beyond this trilogy. But these are the first three games on the PS2, but in HD. The first one, the second one, Going Commando, and the third one, Up Your Arsenal. I actually just recently, I think last year, just beat all three of them finally for the first time ever. Amazing series, amazing, and actually holds up still pretty well, so definitely play this. Keeping it moving, Ratchet & Clank Future, which was a brand new trilogy that they started on the PS3. I also just recently beat this last year. Very good start to another trilogy that they started. And then the second game in that Ratchet & Clank trilogy is actually digital only. It's called Quest for Booty, so I never got it and I never played it, but I got the third one, A Crack in Time. This was actually the first PS3 game I ever got. I loved it. I really want to play it again and maybe even get a platinum, because I remember just really, really enjoying it. It was a great way to close out the double trilogy, I guess you could say. Next is the almighty Red Dead Redemption, and guys, please don't exit out of the video, but I have not played this, and I don't know what to do with myself. Keep hoping for a PC release, but I don't think that's gonna happen. I need to play this ASAP. Please. Yes, I know. I need to play it. I will definitely play it before the second one comes out, so don't worry about that. Next, we have what is known as the best launch title for the PlayStation 3, and that's Resistance Fall of Man, made by the same people who made Ratchet & Clank that I just talked about. But this is like a war game, but it's alternate history where you fight like these, I think they're aliens, I'm not sure. It's like World War II, but against aliens, with some crazy scientific weapons. It might sound stupid, but it's actually a lot of fun. It's kind of old school type of first person shooter, at least by today's standards, but the weapons in this game are awesome and I really enjoyed it. I really remember liking this one a lot. Second game of the Resistance trilogy, Resistance 2. I did not beat this game, but I did play it for a few hours. Really liked it. It was a huge upgrade from the first one. This is another series that I really hope they remaster for PS4, because I feel like a lot of people forgot about this series. Last of the Resistance trilogy, Resistance 3. Unfortunately, I have not played it at all, so I can't say much about it. Next, we have Shadows of the Damned. I'm not sure why this is not on PC. Actually, I'm not sure about a lot of things about this game, but I do know that there's a gun that looks like a penis, I think. So any game that has that is worth a try, in my opinion, because it sounds hilarious. Next, I have the Sly Cooper Collection, the first three games from the PlayStation 2. Played the first one, got a platinum in it. It was alright. It's definitely the weakest of the three main mascot platformers from the PlayStation 2 era, which are Jak and Dexter, Ratchet and Clank, and then the Sly Cooper series. It was interesting. It's like a kid's stealth game. The second one, for some reason, got me really frustrated, and I didn't finish it. I think I got kind of bored with it. And I never got into the third one. And they actually did try to continue the Sly Cooper series with this fourth game on the PlayStation 3, which I obviously have not tried because I haven't beaten the second or the third one yet. Next we have Soul Calibur 5. I've not played this one, but I would imagine it's the same as most of the other Soul Calibur games. Used to play the crap out of the fourth one on Xbox 360. With the Star Wars characters, the Yoda, the Apprentice. I remember in that game, you just be kicking ass, and then you're one hit away from winning, and your opponent does something, and you fall off the stage and you lose. And that would just create for some hilarious moments. Next, I have the Tom Clancy Splinter Cell Collection, which is the first Splinter Cell, the first ever Splinter Cell. And then the second one, Pandora Tomorrow, and then Chaos Theory. And the reason why I have this collection is because I don't think Pandora Tomorrow is on PC. At least it's not easily accessible, but I haven't played any of them, so I've only played Conviction. That game was really good. I loved it, so I don't know how well these would hold up, but maybe they're worth a try. Next we have WWE 13, which got me back into the WWE series, because before that I lost all interest in the product in WWE, so therefore I didn't know any of the wrestlers in the new games, like WWE 12, I remember getting that and I was like, who are these guys? I have no idea who they are. But in this one, since they brought back the Attitude Era, I knew a lot of the characters, like The Rock. I think they have like Gangrel and stuff on this one too. Like, all those crazy guys. And Val Venus and all that. So I was really intrigued by this game, and it's a lot of fun. WWE games are always a lot of fun. And the last game on my PlayStation 3 is WWE 2K14, which in my opinion is probably the best WWE game since Here Comes the Pain. This was all about the history of WrestleMania, so this had a lot, this had like everybody I ever wanted pretty much, besides like Sting or something. They had Hogan, they had the NWO Macho Man, they had just everything. Goldberg, Brock Lesnar. You could customize everyone's attire, or at least the color. You can give everyone 4 attires, and it didn't take up a creator character slot like the new games. And even the created characters that you could download from online, all of them had 4 attires too. I just love attires and variety, so that's what I really remember about this game. That's what I really liked about this game. Okay guys, so now that I'm done with the PlayStation 3, let's move on to current gen systems. I'm gonna do the Xbox One first because I have the least amount of games for it. Forza Motorsport 6, I love the Forza series, I love the Motorsport series, I love the Horizon series. Although this is probably my least played Forza. I don't know why, I think just a lot of stuff came out around that time. But I did really enjoy it. Every Forza is amazing. I love this one. Forza Horizon 2. This is what made me buy the Xbox One. I waited for about a year or however long it took for this to come out. Totally worth it. I absolutely love this. I don't have the third one on Xbox One, but I do have it on PC. So yeah, you're not going to be seeing that one. But this was awesome. Even though the third one is, of course, it's better in every way. Next, I have Gears of War Ultimate Edition, which is a remaster of the original Gears of War, which was fantastic. And this remaster was fantastic too. It includes some new levels. Well, they're not really new, but back in the day, back in 2006, when the original came out, it also came out on PC later on with bonus levels. So this has the bonus levels. Plus, since I was an early adopter of the game, I also got free download codes for Gears of War, the original, the second one, the third one, and Judgment. So basically, for $40, I got 5 games, which was awesome. Next, we have the Halo Master Chief Collection, which includes Halo 1, Halo 2, Halo 3, Halo 4. And for me, as an early adopter, I got the free code for Halo 3 ODST. I really wish Halo Reach was on here, but obviously that's not Master Chief's story, so that makes sense. But I kind of feel like that's the only Halo that's kind of left behind, and that was a good one. Reach was a good one, but all of them are great. Honestly, this is the only reason why I have not sold or at least put away my Xbox One, because my Xbox One has not been turned on in like a year. And this is the only series pretty much that I can't get anywhere else. Every year or every couple of years, I'm really tempted to play Halo. I'm not really a multiplayer gamer, but I love the single player campaigns in all these games, especially the first three, especially number 2 and number 3. The latest game in the Halo franchise, or at least the first-person shooter part of it, Halo 5 Guardians. This game was okay. Like I said earlier, I'm not really into multiplayer, even though I did have fun. Like, for me to have fun in a multiplayer mode, that means it's a great multiplayer mode. The campaign was, it was decent. It was pretty enjoyable in co-op on Legendary. Playing it on your own, it got a little bit repetitive with those enemies. I forgot what they're called. I'm sure you know which enemies I'm talking about, like the mini-boss person, robot god thing, you know what I'm talking about. Those things are annoying. Next, I have Quantum Break. I really enjoyed this game. I know that a lot of people did not enjoy it. I liked it. I liked the actual game of it. I gotta say, I'm not a big fan of having to watch the TV episodes, because you'd be playing for like 40 minutes and then you gotta sit there and watch 30 minutes of TV. And I'm not really a TV show watcher. Like, I don't even watch stuff on Netflix that much. I mostly watch movies. It was an okay idea, just wasn't executed very well. Next, we have the Rare Collection. This was, I believe, $30 when it came out. This is a bargain. You get 30 Rare games that are not Nintendo exclusive, obviously. So you get the Perfect Darks, you get the Banjo-Kazooies, you get the Battletoads. Super worth it. And the last game for my Xbox One collection, Sunset Overdrive, made by the same people who made Ratchet and Clank. So, of course, this has ridiculous weapons, ridiculous jokes and references. This game is just, like, the definition of fun. It doesn't take itself seriously. You fight zombies who are, like, infected by soda pop, and it's just ridiculous and hilarious. I actually made a video last year, I think, about this game. I kind of want to do a full Let's Play of it. But we'll see. It's sad to me that Microsoft is not gonna really continue with this, because this didn't really sell that well, because Microsoft expects like millions and billions of copies to be sold, but unfortunately this didn't sell very well. The good news is that the Sunset Overdrive franchise actually belongs to Insomniac, so from what I understand, they can make a sequel on PC, on Xbox One, on PS4, sometime later in the future, and I hope they do that. All right, now we're moving on to PS4 with Batman Arkham Knight. Well, I think most of us know the trouble of the launch of the PC version of this game, so I waited and waited for that to get fixed. It didn't get fixed. I mean, it did now, but it took like 2 years or something like that. So I pulled the trigger on this. I got this for $8 along with another game. So this was pretty much $4. Super worth it. The one thing I hate about this game is that you literally have to get a platinum trophy in order to get the ending. Because if you just beat the last boss, you just kind of get the credits and then you spawn on top of a building. And it basically tells you to do every side quest ever, every collectible ever to get the true ending. And for that, this game can go piss off. Next, we have Bloodborne. I never really got into the Dark Souls series. I only played Demon's Souls, and that was extremely difficult. Extremely difficult. When this came out, I was really into my PlayStation 4. I picked up like every game that was coming out. So, of course I picked this up. I played this for 8 hours the first day I got it, and that's how long it took me to make any progress. Because you kinda have to like, it's a big open world, open area, and you have to find like gates and how to open them in order to create shortcuts, because if you don't have the shortcuts, you have to replay the same area over and over and over. And as frustrated as I got, this game is super addictive. There's just something about it, like when you just beat a certain enemy, you just feel like you got promoted at a job or something. You just feel so accomplished. Like no other game makes you feel so good about yourself after completing something. Next we have Dead or Alive 5, Last Round, which is basically the complete edition. I've not played this one. I actually haven't played a Dead or Alive since Dead or Alive 4, when that launched on Xbox 360. But I'm sure this is the same thing. Next is Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls, which is basically the whole Diablo 3 game plus all the DLC and all that. I really like this on the consoles because it's on the PC, you just click and drag your mouse everywhere. I really don't like that. I know that a lot of PC gamers are probably moaning and groaning right now when I say that, but I really like the action aspect of it because I feel like I'm more of in control of what I'm doing because I can roll out of the way to dodge, I can hit whenever I want. You know what I mean? I just like that better. So I really like this game. Next is Drive Club. Very much hated on game. Now, I don't know what it was like, what state it was in when it first came out, because I picked it up much later after its release. But from what I've played, I really, really enjoyed it. The graphics are amazing even to this day. Like, the detail is just incredible. And the weather is just fantastic. It's amazing. It's a pretty bare bones game. A lot of DLC, a bit too much. For my liking. The rubber band AI can get a little bit annoying. I feel like no matter how perfectly I drive, they'll always be on my tail, they'll always pass me up, and that can get annoying. But if you like driving cars and you got a PS4 and you don't have Forza in any way, this is not a replacement for Forza, but it's a good driving game, I think. FIFA 16, not much to say about this one. I do have FIFA 17 on PC. I love FIFA. I will be going back to consoles for FIFA 18. Next, we have my current game of the year for 2017, and that's Horizon Zero Dawn. Absolutely love this game. I love that it's a new IP. It's from Guerrilla Games, the makers of, Killzone. They kind of had a mixed record up to this game, so I wasn't really sure how this was going to turn out, but thankfully it turned out fantastic. Highly, highly, highly recommend this game if you like action RPGs or like open world type games. Next, we're going back to Infamous with Infamous Second Son. This is not really a sequel to the first two games. It's a standalone story, standalone game. This game is so good. Like, this is the best X-Men game that's not X-Men game. You know what I mean? Like, if they made an X-Men game similar to this, it would be awesome. Like, this gave me X-Men vibes. If you guys play this, I'm sure you can agree with me, and I think you know what I mean. Going back to Guerrilla Games, Killzone Shadowfall. This is Killzone only by name. It does not feel like it at all. I did like the innovative controls. I like how this game used the PS4 controller with the touchpad controls, with a little speaker for audio logs. I think that was great. For a launch game, I had a lot of fun with this one. Next we have pretty much the whole Kingdom Hearts saga. It's four complete remasters games and two story summaries, that's what I understand, of two other games. Yeah, I've never played any of them. This is honestly probably the next game I'm gonna play, just in my personal life and on my channel. Because I really gotta slowly prepare for that Kingdom Hearts 3, whenever that's gonna come out. And I love Disney. Next game is The Last Guardian, which I'm sorry, but I really don't like this game. It's just a snooze fest. It's so boring, and it's so annoying to control the bird, dog, dinosaur thing. I don't know what it's called. One thing I'll say is that I'm really happy for the developers, and I'm glad I supported them, because I know they worked hard for like a decade on this game. And I'm glad that they finally put this out for the fans and for themselves, and just, I'm just happy for whoever enjoyed this, but I personally didn't. Next we have a masterpiece, which is The Last of Us Remastered. Beat it on PS3, picked it up right away on PS4, played it again, beat it. Love the multiplayer. I'm not a multiplayer gamer, but I spent probably 100 hours of multiplayer on this. Got every multiplayer trophy, I believe. Love the storyline, love the multiplayer. Love everything. Cannot wait for the second one. Back at it again with Little Big Planet Day 1 Edition, which is like a special edition that I got like for 15 bucks, I think. And it came with a little plush toy, which I have back there. I don't want to dig for it. I mentioned earlier that I'm not into JRPGs, but this game really changed my mind. Persona 5, this is the steelbook. It comes a little plastic thing. This game, I only played for about 12 hours, I believe, so definitely haven't gotten far, definitely haven't beaten it, but I was just so engrossed in the story and the characters. It was so ridiculous, like the whole time I was laughing my ass off, just kept asking myself, what is going on? Like, one of the enemies you fight, it's like a purple gargoyle demon that's sitting on a toilet and he's floating, and you're just fighting it, like, It's so ridiculous, and this game is just super long, and I'm so sorry I haven't had much more time to play it. It's just, if I play this, I'll not play anything else for the next year, probably, so before I die, I will definitely play this game, and I'll definitely beat it, because it's amazing. Next, we have the complete remake of Ratchet & Clank. This is the remake of the first game, but it's like fully remade. Some of the stuff is completely different. I can't say enough good about this game. This is just what gaming's about. I'm just speechless right now. Tearaway Unfolded. I had a Vita for a few months and I got really annoyed with the lack of space on my memory card, and I did not want to spend $100 on a new one. So I sold it for the same amount of money I bought it for, and at the time, one of the top-rated exclusives for it was this, and I never got it. So when this came out on PS4, I bought it, and I haven't played it, so can't speak on it, but I want to check it out someday. It's a really niche game. Next, we have Uncharted, the Nathan Drake Collection. If you don't know by now that I love Uncharted with all my heart and all my every cell of my body, then I don't know what to tell you. Just, if you have a PS4, you need to buy this right now. I actually have all three of them on PS3 still. I didn't show them to you because I only showed you the games that I don't have duplicates of. I have like 100 more games on my PS3 that I didn't show you. That's because I have them all on PC, so yeah, keep that in mind. Just buy this. Just please buy this. Also, please just buy this. Uncharted 4. Are you kidding me? This is the ultimate perfect way of ending the Uncharted series. Okay guys, if you're new to Uncharted, please play 1, 2, 3, 4 in that order. I would say play this no matter what, but all the little references and the ending are just so much better if you play the first three. It just warms your heart. Like, I'm so speechless. I cannot wait for the new one coming out next month. I'm too busy fantasizing about this right now. I can't even remember the name of the new one. The one with Chloe, you know that one, the one that's coming out. Yeah, I can't wait. Next we have Until Dawn. This game was absolutely fantastic. It scared the crap out of me. It's like a teen slasher game in the style of Telltale games, but with like super good graphics and good facial expressions. Just enjoyed this so much. The twists were crazy. The characters, I hated some because I was supposed to, and I loved some because I was supposed to. And this game just kept me guessing over and over and over. I think I'm gonna replay this around Halloween for my channel. I think it will be great. I really hope they make a sequel or something similar to this, because this was fantastic. And now the last game for my console collection, WWE 2K17. The roster is pretty great. It has pretty much anyone you can think of. The created characters are amazing nowadays. People just create some amazing wrestlers. Kind of excited about the new one coming out, 2K18, but I'm always on the fence about these because I never know if they're gonna end up being good or not. So there you guys have it, my console gaming collection. This is just the tip of the iceberg, guys, and this took forever. Just imagine if I did 500 more PC games, because that's what I have on my PC, around 500 games. And I'll be doing those tomorrow, guys, so I hope you enjoyed this. Please leave a like if you did, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow with the rest of my collection. My camera just fell over. So, you know, it's time to wrap it up.